So in this series of videos, we're going to look at installing an EV charger. Now, you may recognise the house behind us because it's a house we've been using as part of our smart home takeover. But in this, it's not so much a takeover. We're going to be putting some new kit in the shape of an EV charger. Now, a lot of people ask us, how easy is that process? Well, the process can be incredibly easy if you're right next to the supply coming into the house and you've got a parking area at the front. But in this, if you look around us here, that's not quite so easy unless you want to demolish the wall, lower the curb and re-tarmac the front garden. So, where can we park? Where's Gary?
Luckily, the property has a designated parking space here at the back of the property, and this is where the EV charger is going to be installed. However, we couldn't be any further away from the consumer unit if we tried. We're going to go back to the origin of the supply, and we want your input in the comments. Please give us all the ideas, tips and techniques you believe that are going to need to be done by the electrician in order to get the supply to here for an EV charging point.
So we're here at the origin of the supply. Few important things we need to find out here before we get started. Is there enough power coming into the property in the first place? Now, we're still going to need to notify the DNO when we do the EV install, but looks like we're in luck here because there's a 100 amp fuse labelled up there. Next thing, what about that earthing system? Because that's going to affect how we connect to our EV charger. Again, you can see that's a TNCS earthing system. So again, some choices there to make. And handy, the DNO's fitted a double pole isolator for us so we can obviously disconnect the supply safely should we need to add any additional equipment at this end.
So inside at the consumer unit, it is plastic, but when I drop it down, there are no spare ways. We've also got solar PV in there, which may come in handy as we go through the installation, but the RCDs themselves, we've got two RCCBs and they are AC RCDs. So there's a bit of a dilemma here. Do we install a separate consumer unit, metallic, in the hallway? It's obviously not going to look the greatest. Or do we need to change this board to allow for a further extension of the wiring system? In other words, our new circuit and other new circuits in the future.
So we've got the consumer unit mounted in the hallway downstairs. Now, okay, not the best place, not the best, but you know, do you really want to look at your consumer unit when you walk up and down the stairs? But that's not the end of the problems. Next one, it's actually mounted underneath these stairs here. So how do we get the cable underneath those stairs down to the consumer unit? Let's have a look at the flooring. So if we just peel back the carpet here, you can see, as you expect, chipboard flooring, and obviously the boards, they're running that way, which means the joists are running this way. So there's another dilemma. Again, we're gonna have to drill a lot of joists to get the cable from the front to the back. So let's have a look. Oh, and it doesn't end there. So we've got a bathroom and the floor's been tiled. It's got electric underfloor heating, so we don't want to disturb that. So then we have, oh, watch it, Gary, savage animal in there. We've got to cross that bedroom floor to get to the back wall of the property.
This property already benefits from solar PV. I've got the inverter behind me, but is that another consideration for the type of EV charger that we could select for this property? Will it mean that we'll have to install some CT clamps somewhere in the system as well? And if we do so, does that mean then that that energy can be rediverted to the car and we can drive around on sunshine?
So just when we thought we'd managed to escape the building, this dilemma comes along. We've got a section here, flat fiberglass roof, underneath it supported in the living room by an RSJ. So how are we going to get the cable past this obstacle down to Gary?
And then I've got to come down the wall. Behind the actual downpipe, there's already a steel armoured and a couple of SY flexes. I've got to come underneath the decking. I've got gravel. I've got paving. Can I secure the new cable to this, the fence, in order that I can get to the back of the property where our EV charging point's going to be installed?
So I've had the old estate agent's measurements out, and actually I make this about, oof, I don't know, 200 metres from the consumer. No, seriously, measured it at 30 metres or there or thereabouts. Well, add a little bit of tolerance in there, but that's quite a distance. You know, what we're going to put in, 7 kilowatt charger, that's the maximum you can have on a UK domestic installation. So we think volt drop is going to be the big issue. Will we get away with a 6 millimeter cable? Will we have to go up to 10 millimeters, which adds obviously bigger holes, a bigger cable to conceal?
Well, that's some route to get us to here. All it means now is we pass over the cable length to Joe in order that he can do the calculation for us. My final dilemma is, can I secure the EV charging point here on this fence by the side of the parking space? We're interested in your comments, especially on this video. We want them below and we will try and get back to as many as we can. Check out the next video to see if your comment got implemented in the next video.